president of the Nigeria Society of Engineers, Engineer Oti Sayenji, addressed the World Press recently in Abuja to draw the attention of the federal government to the need to use the engineering-based initiative to get the nation out of the current recession. We have the full report and also the press briefing in total, plus other interesting issues on business, finance, and the economy. This is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Hello, a very good day to you and thanks for joining us. My name is Kenneth Odushola Stevenson and this is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. The president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Oti Sayenji, has drew the attention of the federal government to the need to use engineering-based initiative to get the nation to the part of prosperity and out of this current recession. We have a full build of the press conference, the World Press Conference addressed in Abuja, right after this commercial break.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers is breaking his silence to add his voice to the clamor for good governance. At a news conference on the state of the nation, the engineers described the current downturn in the economy as a wake-up call on the authorities and the citizenry to think out of the box. The society believes reviving the automotive industry as well as the iron and steel sector are sure ways of getting out of economic recession.
Putting such a key industry needed for national industrialization in private hands at this stage of our development was, to say the least, ill-advised. The industry's decline has been caused by challenges which include infrastructural inadequacies and macroeconomic instability, leading to low level of output.
And reacting to government's plan to dispose some of the nation's assets, the engineers call for caution.
The status of our nation is not ripe enough to sell our performing assets and gas assets. The non-performing petroleum assets, the refineries, and their captive petroleum plants can be put forward for sales after some professional evaluations. It needs to be realized that the country, in fact, sold out partly with the joint operating agreements and succeeding agreements.
The society is admonishing the government to tap into the initiatives of professional groups to achieve viable economic growth.
In the opinion of Nigerian engineers, Mr. President has to recognize that the next 2.5 years have to be a revolutionary period in government and also business. He has to believe in and tap into the capacity of Nigerians and Nigeria for rebirth and renewal, as already witnessed in the entertainment, communications, banking, and other industries.
The NSE says it is in tandem with the reduction in the number of ministries, but charges the Buhari administration to appoint more ministers for greater efficiency and effectiveness.
You're still inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Thanks for staying with us. Indeed, the concern by many Nigerians, especially in the recent recession that is currently plaguing the country, is also receiving attention of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. And these are the infrastructure development professionals. And indeed, they've been calling on the federal government to take a look at the engineering-based initiative to get the nation on the path of economic prosperity and get it out of the recession. To this end, the society put together a World Press Conference to address the needy issues and also provide some solutions to get the nation out of the recession. Today on Inside Business Africa, we'll give you some excerpts from that important World Press Conference by the Nigerian Society of Engineers.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers recognizes that the task facing the nation at this critical period, beset with economic decline, revolves around the following leadership responsibilities. 1. Creating an inspiring and consistent vision. 2. Reassessing governments and the nation's core missions in the light of Mr. President's clear picture of the future. 3. Selecting, recruiting, retaining, and using and developing appointees and employees. 4. Managing change within the State House, the public service, and providing enabling development for change in the private sector and preparing for global change. 5. leveraging technology to improve public sector operations and delivery of services therefrom to citizens. 6, using local talents, local technologies, and local goods and services as inputs to infrastructural and economic development projects. We look at the issue of Mr. President as executive in chief. Nigerian citizens, public and media appreciate and glorify the glamour attendant upon the president's role as commander-in-chief, fondly called CNC. On the other hand, Mr. President's role as executive-in-chief attracts very little attention, whereas it is performance in this latter role that can make or mar the polity, the economy, and the environment. As of today, the Nigerian citizenry has become alert enough to expect high-quality service from government, business, and the non-profit sectors. Nigerian engineers thus sense the president has to adopt strategies that would ensure that, from now, in performing government responsibilities, both the public servant working in government agencies and the agency as a whole must perform optimally and to the satisfaction of the citizenry. The key word here is perform, since elected public servants are also expected to perform, not to learn. We will assess government's and the nation's core mission. As the leader of the Nigerian organization, Mr. President should personally lead the assessment of Nigeria's mission to determine if we as a nation are in the right businesses, what the accumulated or missed missions and the extent of house cleaning to be done, selecting appointees and employees. Engineers are of the view that the success of Mr. President's role as executive in chief would hinge on his success in attracting and selecting talent for both political appointees and employees in public service. Thus, it is expected that the president will be personally involved in the interviewing process and not abdicate this responsibility to state governors and political party chieftains. Such persons are nominated for specific ministerial portfolios, and if a nominee is screened for a particular ministry and is deemed competent for that position, he or she is appointed to go and perform. If such a person fails, he or she is dropped, as there is no room for cabinet reshuffle in the presidential system. Engineers know that politicians have enough latitude to destroy the landscape like Colossus, having in the National Assembly 469 positions, over 700 seats in state assemblies, and over 7,000 places in the local government councils that are elected. Ministerial positions are competence-based and sensitive to performance. For the sake of performance and quality executive service to the citizenry, Nigerian engineers, on behalf of Nigerian professionals, demand that the president constitutes his cabinet with 60% technocrats and 40% politicians. In making this demand, engineers strongly recommend to Mr. President to depoliticize the selection process and demystify the senior screening exercise by attaching portfolios to those nominated for ministerial appointments. For engineering-based ministries, the president is advised to appoint engineers as ministers or ministers of state to lead them, merging of ministries. As can be seen, countries usually bundle up sectors of government businesses into ministries. What then is optimum number of ministries varies from country to country. The United States maintains 15 ministries, or 18 if one includes Department of Army, Department of Navy, and Department of Air Force, each headed by a full secretary, in addition to the Department of Defense. The United Kingdom has 22 ministries, while Singapore, smaller than Lagos, has 15 ministries. These countries have managed to keep the number of ministries low through bundling of allied sectors of government businesses into a ministry.
Stay stay with Inside Business. We'll be right back and continue with that important Nigeria Society of Engineers World Press Conference addressed by the President, Engineer Otis Ayenji, on Thursday, the 20th of October 2016. Stay with Inside Business. We'll be right back.
And energy ministry can be created from petroleum, gas, power, and solid minerals. Such a ministry will require about 6 ministers and ministers of state. A transportation ministry should be created to manage all the modes of transportation: highways, rail, aviation, maritime, and you will need 5 ministers and ministers of state to handle this. In the social sectors, a Ministry of Human and Social Services to manage women affairs, youths, social welfare, and sports can be operated with 5 ministers and ministers of state. With our industrial engineering background, we can assist Mr. President in designing a sustainable governance structure, leveraging technology. Mr. President, using technology in discharging his executive functions, can quickly begin to realize substantial and unprecedented gains in productivity by cashing in on the information age. In doing this, he must be wary of implementing technology solutions that would amount to automating obsolete or obsolescent processes. The President needs to use competent Nigerian professionals to undertake a comprehensive examination of how work flows through government and first identify processes that need to be revised, replaced, or simply eliminated. The challenge ahead. In the opinion of Nigerian engineers, Mr. President has to recognize that the next 2.5 years have to be a revolutionary period in government and also business. He has to believe in and tap into the capacity of Nigerians and Nigeria for rebirth and renewal, as already witnessed in the entertainment, communications, banking, and other industries. Clearly, the time is ripe or even overdue for similar revolution in the government's public sector, intellectual property rights. On economic development, Mr. President needs to remember that the rapid and great advancement made by the United States in science, engineering, and technology is attributable to a clause in their constitution that protects intellectual property rights. Vision 2020, or more likely Vision 2030, plans for an 11-year period of rapid economic growth, transforming Nigeria to a manufacturing economy. This implies making use of advanced manufacturing technologies to cope with higher quality goods and depends on provision and enforcement of intellectual property rights. Presently, intellectual property rights system, patents, trademarks, copyright, technology acquisition and promotion, etc., are disorganized, flung and scattered into several inappropriate ministries. This has resulted in overdevelopment of intellectual property law and undercreation of intellectual property. Public finance for economic development. The attention of the President is drawn to the fact that Japan expedited economic growth after the Second World War with a policy-based finance system by which public funds were channeled to the private sector through their fiscal investment and loan program and the Japan Development Bank to realize set national developmental goals. Engineers note that government in the past has mooted the idea of setting aside special funds for the power, textile, automotive, aviation, and lately entertainment sectors, but nothing significant has been achieved so far. Statements of intentions alone, we believe, is not enough to revamp an economy that is steeped in socio-political crisis and economic recession. Sale of national assets to finance government programs. The status of our nation is not ripe enough to sell our performing assets and gas assets. The non-performing petroleum assets, the refineries, and their captive petroleum plants can be put forward for sales after sound professional evaluations. It needs to be realized that the country, in fact, sold out partly with the joint operating agreements and succeeding agreements in the oil sector. The invitation to exploit national resources should be as a contractor working for the asset owner, in this case Nigeria, represented by the Nigerian government. Such a contract ordinarily should be only a relatively small fraction of the value of the asset. From inception, Nigeria gave free hands to the contractors. Efforts to hold back a reasonable percentage in the joint operating agreements with the introduction of the petroleum industry bill has been resisted by vested interests. The National Assembly should, as soon as practicable, pass the PIB and remit to Mr. President for assent. Rather than go for conventional direct financing, the government should resort to project financing, employing a carefully engineered financing mix on large-scale projects like pipelines, refineries, electric power plants, hydroelectric projects, highways, rail projects, water supply projects, etc., energy sector, oil and gas. Engineers urge the federal government to urgently find a solution to the continual unrest in the Niger Delta, which has resulted in the incessant blow-up of pipelines. In addition to this, the government has to focus on expediting the review and passage of the National Oil and Gas Policy Bill, PIB, and soon after usher in a new generation forward-looking State of the Industry Petroleum Act. The government needs to take urgent steps to restore normalcy and ensure that the resources derived from the Niger Delta are also used to develop the region in order to increase the national oil production capacity and improve significantly employment in the region. The energy sector, electric power. From the state of the electric power sector, there is need to draw the attention of Mr. President to the difference between reform and development. Reform got a functional area support service to a business. Normal government business and commission is about development. If economic development is pursued, reform can find space. But if reform is pursued as the core mission of government, development might elude such a people. Thus, the National Energy Development Master Plan needs to be urgently reviewed. The reviewed energy document should be passed on to the National Assembly for enactment into an energy law, which will make it mandatory for every successive administration to implement. Once again, we acknowledge and thank Mr. President for his recent appointments at the Nigerian Electricity Regulatory Commission with the nomination of an engineer as chairman and two other engineers as commissioners. Mr. President should also ensure that the essence of Nigerian content development is enforced within the power and other sectors to replicate the policy as currently enforced with the oil and gas industry. Competent companies owned and operated by Nigerian technical professionals should always be given the choice of first refusal in all respects. This will guarantee local capacity building, which will be consistent with the Nigerian content policy of the government. The benefits will include employment generation, cheaper electricity, and real capacity development of our expertise in country capital retention. One of the urgent tasks the President should embark upon is to set a time frame for active diversification of energy sources for power generation: hydro, oil and gas, coal, wind, biomass, solar, tidal, etc. The government is urged to implement a hydropower scheme that will realize the Mambila, Lokoja, and Onitsha dams, among others. Our recommendations on this are that the regulator should insist that all NIPP disco installations should be utilized. The regulator should not change the date of deployment of prepaid meters. Should be regular auditing of value discos and added since purchase. Implementation of letter of credit to pay GENCOs and TCM, or full implementation of the market rules. The funding of TCM to reduce transmitting bottlenecks. Government insisting on performance of gas supply by the international oil companies and Nigerian gas company. In summary, NEC, as a matter of justice, should allow market rule to kick in. It has been severally postponed since 2014. Once each operator is paid its contribution, we should commence to get quality power and in a short while get adequate power. The lack of payment to GENCOs may soon make many of them to shut down. NIPP is running aground because of over 100 billion owed her. Security companies, O&M, and many other essential services in the power stations are owed. Gas companies are owed, and this is reducing their investment capacity, the federal government initiative notwithstanding. We go to manufacturing. Manufacturing is all about transforming comparative to competitive materials, using energy competitively and with minimal impact on environment, machine tools. The place to start is through developing capacity for making machines that make machines, that is, machine tools. There are machine tools complexes in Abeokuta, Ovia Alaja, Oshogbo, which are lying fallow. These have to be rehabilitated and recommissioned into commercial activities. More machine tools factories will need to be established for increased and further diversification of product slates. Chemicals. Nigeria's hydrocarbon sources, coal, oil, and gas, double as industrial feedstocks for fine organic industrial chemicals, benzene, toluene, xylene, and organic acids of mixes of industry and appropriate application of technology for optimal achievement of results. This all-in-one presentation of requisite materials, energy, opportunities to produce and market offers Nigeria strategic, economic, social, and political menu, which should not be taken lightly. It is like a horse rider who has horse himself, is fit and able and available, and there is a field to run, and there are spectators, and they still waiting. Automotive. The easiest and fastest means of industrializing Nigeria now is by government encouraging and supporting local entrepreneurs to lead the drive for attraction of foreign investment to build local automotive assembly and component manufacturing capacity. The importance of housing as a sector recommends it as an independent full ministry, rather than as always an appendage to highways. Soil investigation is a major parameter in the failure of engineered facilities, e.g. roads, buildings, bridges, and the National Building Code pays little attention to this. Given the frequency of building collapse in Nigeria, the government needs to support getting soil investigation done on every engineered land improvement project and ensure that standards are adhered to strictly across all facets of construction activities.
It's not only in construction that you have made it germany, made it Italy, and so on, but the passion for foreign goods and services is so much in our country that it is incomprehensible that we could be doing, we could be behaving like that. E.g., a lot of Nigerians do not even know 50% of the state capitals in Nigeria. But if you ask them about Europe, they will tell you a lot of things about them. And not to talk of the passion that goes into even sports in our country. On Saturdays, you hear people talking about Chelsea, Man U, and all this. But they don't talk about Golden United and Rangers International and so on. So it's a thing that we really need to change our mindset, that what is yours, and no other person can develop your country, especially when it comes to physical, you know, infrastructure, than yourself. Because these people, when you are in trouble, if you do not have money, for example, to buy a DSTV code, okay, those ones will never give you money to go and do it because you are a fan of money. The same thing with our roads and infrastructure. If you do not have money to pay heavily for them, there is no way these people will say, for the sake of, we did it for you, okay, let us assist you in repairing it free of charge. It happens. And so I think it's time we really talk about making Nigeria both physical and mentally. Let us all have a mindset that when we use what is made in Nigeria, we are helping our brothers. And look at it this way. In other areas, like politics, we could have our differences, but we do not let foreigners come and govern us.
Fantastic speech by the president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. I can assure you that this particular speech will be with the president this week, especially in relation to the way and manner we can get out of this recession. The Nigerian economic team also, this federal government, to take a look at this speech very thoroughly and see what can be inputted into the entire budget of 2017 to get the nation out of the recession. Indeed, we are very proud of the society and continue to be proud to be associated with the progress and the contribution the society is making to the Nigerian's growth and development. It's been Kenneth Odishola Stevenson presenting Inside Business Africa. Thank you again for watching. See you next week.